you need to understand the basic physiology. What I mean by the basic process that happened for a woman to achieve natural conception. What do you mean by natural? The one that it doesn't require anybody, you know, doing anything so spectacular to happen. That particular woman in question must have a good womb, all right? And this very one also must have an ovary. Ovary is the bag of the egg of a woman, anyway. So it's usually two, one this way, one this other way. That very woman must have an ovary, and also there will be a link between the womb and this very ovary is called fallopian tube. This very fallopian tube is a very tiny tube that enables both the egg and the sperm meet together to be able to form a baby. An interesting thing I will explain to you here is that in natural conception, every month, a woman will produce one egg, and that very egg will drop inside this very fallopian tube. We call it ovulation. So ovulation is the time a woman releases her egg, which if she meets her husband or the spouse at that time, the chances of achieving pregnancy will be high. You get that one very clear? Interesting. So you have something that the egg drops here, and coincidentally, that same moment of ovulation, the husband meets her here, drops the semen or the sperm here, it goes into the womb, passes the womb, and meets the egg inside this fallopian tube. In other words, the formation of the baby, the starting of the life of every baby, is not right here in the womb, because you need to get that right. It happens inside the fallopian tube, what is called fertilization. All right, it happens in that the fallopian tube. Thereafter, it could now be carried into the womb where you have enough room prepared, and then the baby can grow there. All right, so let your guess be as good as mine before we go into this other one. If a woman has black fallopian tube, you know, the unfortunate thing about it is that some couple will meet a doctor, and a doctor following investigation like HAG, hysterosalpingogram, and we lay this very couple, hello sir, oh my dear, your fallopian tubes are blocked. Funny enough, they will leave the office of the doctor without understanding the implication of a woman having blocked fallopian tube. You will meet them 5 years later, 10 years later. They will not tell you there was a time a doctor told us that the fallopian tubes are blocked. You know, most of the cases say we have flushed it. Flushed what? The implication of what God has said that you have fallopian tube is indirectly saying that all the days of your life, medically speaking, that you may not be able to achieve pregnancy. And he's driving that very deduction from the father, by reason of this fallopian tube and this one block, your husband's sperm will travel and stop before the block, and also your egg will come and stop before the block. So the possibility of achieving pregnancy under blocked fallopian tube is zero, medically speaking. Apart from the issue of the fallopian tube, you ask the question is that how could someone know whether the woman has a good womb or not? All right? As earlier mentioned, the current technological support in assisted reproduction actually defines something very unique. That as long as a woman has a good womb, that woman can carry a baby up to 9 months as it were. How do we then know, as you rightly ask, whether this very woman coming in looking very healthy is carrying a good womb? Or a woman that is looking malnourished, perhaps not have been able just to have the money to take care of herself, could she be said to be the one carrying good womb? It is not a function of the look. It's a function of going a little more invasive procedure that will be able to reveal that. And to know whether a woman has a good womb or a bad womb or semi-bad womb or whatever you may call it, there is a procedure that is called hysteroscopy, a camera evaluation of that very womb that will be able to tell How good is this very womb? And that has to do with going in here. This is what is called hysteroscopic evaluation. Hysteroscopic in the sense that the camera goes inside and get all of the findings and project it to a monitor, just like we are seeing right now. This womb is good. This cup-like area you are seeing now is where the baby will stay, and it is quite good. Medically speaking, this woman has an assured possibility of achieving pregnancy, only time and chance. You understand? But let's look at another woman's womb right now, which will go a very, very long way. If you look at this, you find out that this womb has actually become very bad, as a matter of fact. So it is heavily infected. So this kind of womb will not be able to achieve pregnancy for any reason. All right? The option that will be available for this woman, if found early, is for her to go for what is called surrogacy. Another striking factor also is the presence of foreign body. Foreign body could be bone, foreign body could be IUCD, foreign body could be anything that is not the conventional. If you have a look at this one, after this one was done, you can see bones of uncompleted abortion. Abortion that was not properly completed, and he found out that the bones of their baby was left inside. So this woman got married years and years and years, and nothing possible happening here. Do you understand what I mean? So that is fundamentally what could be found in some people's womb. When we say, how could this woman be able to carry this thing and nothing is happening? Yes, it is possible. So, but it's only this level of evaluation that will be able to give such information, you know. So, and also you can find cases of this kind. You can see something like fibroid sitting where the baby ought to be. So, for a woman like this, if you get to do, even if it's IVF or ICSI, as soon as the embryo is dropped inside this womb, this father here will say, don't you know your father? Get out. You will just kick the baby out. That's why most times, when you have fibroid, the chances of pregnancy loss or issue of miscarriage could also happen. So, these are some of the things that could be quite revealing. And when this is kind of a thing is found, attention needs to be given to it. Otherwise, even if you do IVF, you will fail before you start.
Hello, I'm Pastor Barrister Austin Nnadi, the country director of Dr. Save a Life Foundation. I'm inviting you to join this life-changing and destiny-reforming foundation today. You can be part of it by calling those numbers that are running on your screen right now, or visit our website on www.drsavealife.org. Together, we can save a life.
You and your health with Dr. Richard Okoye. Now on AIT, every Monday by 9:30 a.m.
The summary of this is that every woman as it stands now, irrespective of the age, menopause notwithstanding, could be able to achieve pregnancy, you know. But most important, as we have seen here, is that womb must be good. So if it is found to have fibroid, then that fibroid has to be removed. If it is found to be like the one we have a bone, of course, you have to take off those foreign bodies. And you know what? In most of those cases, they may have a foreign body like this kind of bones following abortion, or you have something like a leftover IUCD. Most of them, when you take those things out, they can achieve pregnancy on their own if the time is still there. You know, that's one beautiful advantage of it. And also, if there is a case of endometrial poly, or you have a situation where the womb gum together because of abortion or something that happened over miscarriages and other, and the womb gum together, for such a woman that may not have been able to see her period, or that the period dropped by the number because the womb gone together. You know, you can have the doctor say you have Asherman syndrome, or you have amenorrhea traumatica, or you have what is called uterine synechia. Any of them, they mean the same thing. What they mean is that the womb gone together. So that particular one, if it is not so massive, that very person may benefit from what is called hysteroscopic adhesiolysis, a breakdown of that particular chain, and then see how the womb will be able to be. I think it is also something that you can benefit here. If you have a look at this one, you'll be able just to see there's obviously a block, you know, there's a garment together here, but you can see a hysteroscopic scissors or grasper being able just to clear off that particular obstacle to enable the inside be seen. All these are actually challenges, but it is good that if a woman's womb is good, invariably you can have a very fantastic result when it has to do with this assisted reproductive technology. I do hope you understand it. You know, it's not a mystery, it's something that can be replicated, but to be sure of what it is, the person has to be properly evaluated. We thank God that it's happening in our own time, because most of them in that caliber or in that class would have ended without a child.